Hi folks, this is Davidism Kwon here, and in this video I want to generally talk about feminism, very generally. It is a, now I realize it's a very loaded term, and it's kind of coming to be a very taboo word for a lot of people in American media. Now there's kind of celebrities saying, oh no, I'm not a feminist, and you know, that's, it's been this kind of very loaded term, and people are like, they get very armed up. And there are some people who are like, oh, you guys need a different word because, you know, you can't really just focus on women all the time. There are issues that affect men too, you know, and that's kind of the one of the rhetoric that comes about. And it's like, oh, why don't you just call yourselves egalitarianist or whatever instead of feminist? But like I said, I just think there's a lot of misconceptions and misassumptions about this movement and this phrase. And also there's this assumption now that every feminist is kind of like, I feel like the critics of feminism have this straw man feminist in mind. It's not like, okay, one of the problems is there are a lot of people who kind of take this term and say, I am a feminist because, or feminism is needed because da 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 da, and they kind of, they don't understand feminism either, a lot of them. A lot of them do think it's about kind of, this aspect that women are being disproportionately harmed, and that women need to kind of have a more powerful, more say and more power in the society. I mean, sure, that is actually a part of feminism, but feminism as a whole, as a history, is actually not. It's deeper than that. It's more complicated and more complex than that. But I'm going to try to be really colloquial here and not get into too into the nitty-gritty of feminism. But what I want to say, what I want to begin with is this. The word feminism is not necessarily about women. I know feminism sounds a lot like female, but the history of the movement, feminism really begins with the word feminine. And this is a society where anything that was weak or inferior or just, you know, just kind of a way to discredit what had kind of a feminine adjective to it. Feminine had a really negative stereotypical connotation. So the people who recognized this and kind of saw the injustice of this, because it heavily impacted women too, because women were viewed as feminine, and feminine is viewed as inferior, weak. They said, well, let's take this word and really own it so that it doesn't mean that. It means more, we're taking this power that you what you consider as inferior and as weak, well, we're going to say it is actually a force of strength and force of power. So that's kind of the beginning of feminism. Feminism is less about women than it is about inequality and power. So that's why feminism can actually be broadened not only to women, but issues of race, issues of sexuality, issues of income inequality. It can go all sorts of ways. It is a very broad movement that can be taken to kind of to that level. What you're seeing nowadays on the internet is from American cultural feminists. So that's a specific brand of feminism that I really hope that people start to understand. There are many, many, many kinds of feminism, and not every feminist agrees with other feminists. One of the most obvious example is the tension between neoliberal feminists, or they have many names, but neoliberal feminists can also be libertarian feminists, or there can also be economic feminists. People who kind of hear that term, well, you're going to immediately think they're capitalists, right? They're capitalist feminists. There are people who think changing the way the markets work, increasing minimum wage, making a gender equality legislation, whatever, changing the way the markets work can actually level the playing field between people who are oppressed and people who have privilege. This is economic feminism in a nutshell. This is very crude. It's not very accurate. It's not totally accurate the way I said it, but there's that. But there's also Marxist feminists, and obviously, you probably have an idea why they would not agree with each other. So Marxist feminists would actually believe that there needs to be a revolution that changes the entire capitalist society in order for the oppressed peoples to have equal power and equal opportunity and equal access to power. Obviously, they're not going to agree with each other. Those are two different kinds of feminists. There are many different kinds of feminists. This is what I want to say. You know, there is the American cultural feminist, which is completely cultural feminists being they try to address the kind of inequality or injustice that gets perpetuated or that gets portrayed through the media, like comic books and video games and whatnot. Those are cultural feminists. And I think on the internet, a lot of the people who are critics of feminism, that's all they see. Oh, they just care about comic books and video games and how women are portrayed. You know, the feminists are all about first world problems. Not really. Those are cultural feminists. You know, but there are many other kinds of cultural feminists. So American cultural feminists tend to be more prudish, I want to say. You know, they're more concerned about how women are sexualized and objectified and things like that, or how men are the male characters. They kind of go off on male power fantasies that kind of perpetuate kind of gender inequality and things like that in society, whatnot. I think this is, for American cultural feminists, this kind of matters a big deal because of the issues of eating disorders and suicidal ideation and cutting that is really prevalent among the LGBT population and female population. You know, so that's kind of a big deal. But if you go to a country like Argentina, the cultural feminists from Argentina, Latin American cultural feminists, are going to have a completely different view. So, for instance, Spider-Woman comic book that just came out, the cover art. I know, like, a lot of the American cultural feminists kind of had a freak out about that, which I can kind of understand. If you go to Argentina and show them that, their response will be very different, because the cultural feminism in Latin America is more about kind of, so like I said, American cultural feminists are more concerned with sexualization or sexual objectification, whereas Latin American feminists are more concerned with sexual liberation. So I guess they would be okay with the Spider-Woman comic, but it has to kind of convey also that this woman is, the Spider-Woman is intending to be, you know, wanting to be in a sexual pose that way or wanting to show nudity that way. It has to show agency. It can't be because a man or an oppressive power structure ordered this woman to be this way, but it has to be because of woman's choice about sexual liberation. That's kind of the distinction to be made between Latin American feminism and American feminism. You see, there are many kinds of feminism. That's all I want to really kind of point out there to you. And it's a history of movement that is about addressing the issues of people who are at the bottom end of society, people who are oppressed or people who are discriminated upon, people who have less advantages simply because of who they are. So that's why when we get into feminism like power analysis feminism, that's a big one, and postmodern feminism, that really focuses on people who identify a certain way, and because of that identity, they are denied access, they're denied opportunities, and they are harmed. You know, there are policies that are created to really oppress these people who identify a certain different way than the normative identities of society. That's what this kind of feminism focuses on. It's not only about women. You know, I mean, why is it so much about women? It's only because women happen to be part of the identity, part of the population that gets so much discrimination, so many injustice, you know, unequal opportunity, and equal access, and all those kind of things. That's why feminism is really focused on how women are treated. But it also matters how men are treated as well, because cultural feminism, to me, this is the cultural feminism that I like, is we want to change the culture, cultural perception and cultural stereotypes to have a more a fair society. It's not always about egalitarianism. For example, why can't feminists call themselves egalitarians? Well, there's an issue like this. maternity leave, right? So, or and paternity leave. Women get pregnant, and so women should get special privileges when they are pregnant and they need to do, you know, give birth to children, because that's fair. You know, if we have an egalitarian society, well then everyone should be treated exactly the same way. That's kind of difficult when you say, oh, you know, men can be drafted to the army. Why not women? Why not pregnant women? Right? Let's make it totally egalitarian. as a feminist, that would be like, no, it's not always about egalitarianism. Being an egalitarian, like, it's important, but it's not always just in some cases. And those are the cases where I think, you know, feminism and egalitarianism is going to be in conflict, whatever. But it's, my point is pretty simple. Feminism is a lot more complex, has a really long history, and it's more buried and more deeper than what generally people assume feminism to be. So my concern is when people are like, when female celebrities are like, oh no, I'm not a feminist because I think men deserve equal rights as well. I think that's a stupid comment because that's a, like, what do you think feminism is? You know, I think feminism is not saying let's take power away from men and give it to women. That is not feminism. I can barely think of any brand of feminism that advocates for that. There are many kinds of feminism, but I can't think of any kind of feminism that advocates for that, you know? And there are a lot of people who think feminism is misandry or, you know, or sexism against men, which it can be, depending on who's claiming the term feminism, but the actual movements of feminism doesn't advocate for that. So, you know, know the movements, know feminism, understand, research feminism, because I think a lot of what gets thrown out in the internet is total misassumptions and misconceptions by many people. But you just gotta know, whatever you think feminism is, we all should kind of study more on that. But the basic message of feminism is that there are structures, there are institutions, and there are policies that we all are affected by. And how we are affected by those policies differ based on who you are. As a Korean person, as a man, if you're a straight person, if you're a gay person, if you're an immigrant, if you're a US citizen, it impacts differently. And some institutions and some policies favor certain people over others. And those kind of favoritism and those kind of biases can have life or death kind of impact. It can be really, really serious for some people. Some people end up dying because of policies. Some people end up poor because of policies. And that's the kind of thing that feminism wants to shed our focus on and wants to change. One thing I do think is true about all brands of feminism, whatever kinds of feminism is, one thing is certain: it's not satisfied with the status quo. All feminists believe that the system that we have currently, the society that we have right now, is not good enough. It needs to be changed, improved, or there needs to be revolution. So all feminists believe that. So I guess if you're comfortable with the status quo, then yeah, you would be threatened with feminism, because feminism wants to change things. It wants to improve things, it wants to revolutionize things. So that can be kind of, oh no, I have it good. Why do you want to change what good I have? So that can be the kind of the tension that you have here. But the kind of change that feminism is preaching for might not necessarily be what you are scared of, you know? So that's my talk in a nutshell about feminism. And maybe in a future video, I will go deeper into the kinds of feminism. But for now, I think I spent 14 minutes on this. That's pretty good. So I'll end it there. If you have any questions, whatever, comments, leave them below. I'm happy to discuss. So cheers.